Hiveness with all the energy. I welcome you to MDS Conquer online finish line, which is started this year for MDS first year students for the preparation of their Paper 1. Right now, in this session, I'm going to cover or elaborate the important things that you have to write or you have to highlight when you are taking tests of significance. Okay, as a question. So this question is a commonly asked question for majority of the departments in Paper 1. So first of all, like if you go in detail into the tests of significance, they are categorized into parametric tests and non-parametric tests. Apart from the regular question of tests of significance, the other questions in this area are simply, they can ask you parametric and non-parametric test, or they can ask you write about parametric tests or write about non-parametric tests. Okay, so we'll go in detail. So parametric tests are used when the given data follows the normal distribution. Okay, and I hope you know normal distribution is a curve. Okay, I hope you remember this normal distribution curve. It's a curve in which the mean is equal to the median is equal to the mode. Whereas non-parametric tests, they are used in a cases when the data is squid. It can be a positive or a negative, in which the mean is not equal to the median is not equal to the mode. And parametric tests are regularly used in the cases when the given data is quantitative data which is in numbers, whereas non-parametric tests are regularly used when the given data is qualitative data, means yes or no, good or bad, fair, average, and all these are qualitative data. So the parametric tests are regularly used for the metric scales. They are the interval scale and the ratio scale. Whereas the non-parametric tests are regularly used for nominal scale and ordinal scale. Parametric tests are used in a data when the data clearly represents the mean and the standard deviation. Whereas non-parametric tests are used when the data given is percentages and proportions. Of course, as quantitative will have more preference, parametric tests are more powerful when compared with the non-parametric tests. For example, if your question that is given is write about parametric tests, then before starting or describing the each parametric test, you need to keep a heading like these are the characteristic features that a data should follow for a parametric test. So you can write all these 4, 5 or important points before you starting that. So the next important thing is the tests and their names. Okay, so the most beautiful way of presentation is by a flowchart for this. For example, tests, you can write it as tests of statistical significance, and you can split it into two flowcharts. That is one, the parametric test, and the second one is non-parametric test. Again, you can split the flowcharts into subtypes like 1, 2, 3, 4 or 5 if you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, by which this particular flowchart, okay, this particular flowchart will give a good impression to the person who is correcting your paper, so that this fellow knows everything related to parametric tests and non-parametric tests, and he is well prepared for this. So this is going to give the extra marginal score that is really required. Means presentation should be in the diagrams, presentation should be in the flowcharts, presentation should be seen from an overall point. For such presentations, you will have good scorings in the examination. Okay, so now parametric tests. So parametric tests are of many types. Now whatever the 4 or 5 I have mentioned right now in this PPT are very, very important tests that you should not miss. So the correlationship test that is used for the parametric is this one. The correlation test that is used for the non-parametric is this one. So the unpaid t-test, paid t-test, ANOVA, they comes under parametric tests. Whereas your non-parametric test includes all this. Okay, the detailed description of all these things. Okay, maybe if you have time and if the question is asked and if you have time, you can elaborate few of these tests. For example, t-test, ANOVA test and paid test, are regularly known by most of us. Okay, here you can have the most commonly used is chi square test. We are well known. Okay, so I'm going to post few textbook based things on the group where you can go through and prepare some basic notes, some basic skeleton work. But whatever the skeleton work I have mentioned, the differences between the parametric and non-parametric and this flow chart are very, very important for good scoring for this particular question. Okay, so as already discussed, references are very, very important. Okay, so these are the common references that you can quote for almost all the community-based questions. So whenever there is a community-based or statistical related question, you can quote these references. Okay, these five references are star references that you can follow and quote everywhere. Okay, so I hope I have taken like 3 to 5 minutes for one important question. So this is how we are planning to approach and finish the skeleton work for all the questions, because once you're done with the skeleton work of the most of the questions, for sure you can clear the exam very easily, and there is 100% assurance that you will get more than 60 or 65% of scores in your theory paper. Thank you for now. Signing off, Dr. Srikanth from Team MDS Concord.